Yo, what's up, guys? Corey Sandman Sandhagen here. Welcome to another week of breakdowns. I was just at the fight in Salt Lake City. I really wanted Aldo to win because I thought that he might be the next matchup, but the fight was a little bit, you know, a lot of booze after that one. So let's talk about how Aldo shot himself in the foot, what Batista did pretty well, how he pretty much used control time to balance out the really close striking, and good on him for doing that. Let's get into the breakdown. All right, guys, okay, so Aldo Batista, all right? I thought it was a fairly decent fight. You know, Batista definitely took, like, the safer route, which, you know, if you're fighting a guy like Aldo, maybe that's the decision that you make. But really, Aldo used his jab super well. Batista did a great job of tying up Aldo's arms a lot. Aldo fights, like, with a really tall, like, high guard, kind of like that Brazilian or that Dutch style that you see, where they're kind of here like this. They bounce, they have a little bit of rock. Aldo parries a lot with his backhand, boom, protects himself that way, protects his body. He has like super long arms and kind of a short torso, so it's really hard to score like anything that feels significant when you're trying to punch guys like that. But real good guard here, use the right hand. Mario did a great job of being real bouncy in, out, level changes, throwing to the body, using his jab just to touch. Aldo, I think, kind of was letting him do that in the first round, more or less just because Aldo is very concerned, it seems, with, like, energy conservation. And Aldo also kind of seems like he is okay with maybe, like, giving up a round in order for him to get reads or whatever it is that he's doing in this time where he's blocking and just using a good guard, stalking people down, and then throwing punches. He kind of waited till the second round to do it. So that was how that went. The other piece that we're going to talk about is why Aldo lets people just rack up control time against the cage. I'm not saying that this is the way that things should be scored. I'm just saying that this is the way that things are actually scored. If you have me against the cage, I'm technically losing by the rules a little bit, okay? Or at least in like the traditional sense, which it kind of seems like with the judges, we're in this middle ground of damage is what wins. Control is what wins, which is like the traditional way, okay? And we're kind of like getting to the damage piece, but we're not all the way there, or some of the judges aren't all the way there. And also like in a close round, if it's like the striking is kind of even, which it is against like a lot of these really good guys, when the striking's even and I have you pinned against the cage for a minute and I'm a judge, I'm probably gonna give it to the guy that's pinning the other person against the cage. Especially if it's real close, like that just kind of makes sense in my head. So can't hate on the judges too much for that. If we're going strictly like full damage is the only thing that matters. If you pin me against the cage and I tie up your arms kind of like Aldo does, like Aldo will get a whizzer and then just block on the inside here and really tangle you up and then just chill, defend the shot, chill, defend the shot. If we're talking just damage, then yeah, of course, like Aldo probably won that fight. But when it's real close like that and you're pinned against the cage, you kind of lose. And I can't really say that I disagree with that too much because Aldo could have gotten off the cage, it seemed like, whenever he wanted. Like, Batista's pressure is not like a high underhook, like big, heavy, like making you, like pinning you with my hip and my shoulder here. He was shooting like low shots and Aldo had like plenty of room to start to circle and get himself off the cage, which he did, it seemed like, when he wanted to, but it was just like way too long. So Aldo's biggest mistake in this fight was just letting Batista in that third round, which obviously it was a 1-1 in my opinion going into round three, letting Batista just like pin him against the cage and Aldo just taking a really long time to get off. And then the striking's fairly even. Aldo is definitely winning the striking, especially on like these really long jabs, but Batista also did a really good job of like when Aldo would throw like these big right hands, like Aldo was missing really big here and Batista was kind of like rolling his shoulder or just exiting out this way or kind of leaning and exiting off to his lead side, getting away from that big right hand. So not really a ton to talk about in this fight other than just the way that I feel like Aldo shot himself in the foot by letting Batista pin him up against the cage. Especially because Aldo's lost fights like that in the past. I don't really know the thinking behind that, but good on Batista for being able to beat an Aldo. And really sucks to watch Aldo lose, because that's who I was thinking that I was going to fight next. But another thing that I wanted to say, there's a bunch of ways that we could fix this, guys. Like, we just have to change the rules, which is going to be a giant pain in the ass usually, because each state has their own commission. But I've said for a long time, man, I think that if you are in certain positions, either on the ground or against the cage, you need to have some type of shot clock or takedown clock of some time, because you just let, like, behavior like that, where I'm just going to shoot in, boom, hang out for a while, dig an underhook, hang out for a while, drain the minutes, and I'm technically winning. And then when we break, it's an even striking match. Like, to get away from that, you have to put, like, hey, 15 seconds, or the ref can say, like, hey, 15 seconds, because this isn't working. Like, little tiny, like, knees to the knees or knees to the body, like, unless they're really with some pepper, they're not working. So that's something I've been kind of an advocate for a really long time. When people are against the wall or on the floor and not doing much, like in wrestling, give them like a stall call. They have X amount of minutes or seconds in order to get themselves off of there, and that should be how they should handle that. But yeah, like, subscribe, comment, peace. Love you guys. Bye.